Hello guys, we're back for another video and we're going to continue MyTeam career mode, and this time we're going to be racing in Azerbaijan. Now unfortunately I did order a major engine upgrade, which is this cylinder head, but unfortunately it did not really come in time for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. So yeah, that's why I reordered it, and it'll probably come like right before the next race. Yeah, that is quite unfortunate because Azerbaijan has long straights, and if this upgrade would have come on time, then it would prove useful. But anyways, let's continue on. And I got a...
We're in a position now where we're able to attract a new sponsor for the team. Head on over to the corporate tab and select the sponsor screen to choose who we should attract.
Well, this stinks. I got two upgrade failures. Yep. Well, this stinks. Yep, this stinks. Oh, a rival duel. Let's do this. Interesting. Oh, okay. I hit a wall. Oh, I lost that one. Down the inside. I'll try to block him off a little bit. Oh no, you don't. Now he's in front of me. Oh, that was close. I got a slipstream. All right, yes. Oh. All right. Quality time, I need to see something first. Oops, I forgot to change it to this. Oh, it's like 4 or 5 minutes. Should be fine. Well, my gearbox is wearing out faster than I thought. Okay. I'll skip the repair time. Everyone's out. Well, almost everyone. Let's go. Here we are for the first round of qualifying. Well, in Azerbaijan. Oh. Now, this Azerbaijan has a very long straight, so slipstream would be really useful right about now. Once I get there. P13. Close to the top 10, but okay. Okay, it looks like I'm still P13. We only have like about 4 minutes left in the session. I'll wait for a few more cars to go out. Okay, here we go. Let's go. Okay, here we go. Second round of qualifying, this has to be perfect. Right onto this long straight. Oops. P12. Not that bad. Okay.
With qualifying complete, let's review our top three today. Verstappen, Hamilton, and George Russell. Well, that wraps up qualifying, but don't worry, we'll be back tomorrow as we head into the Grand Prix.
Okay, these are the qualifying results. A 141s for the pole position. All right. Let's see where my teammate is. Oh yeah, I forgot to say that. He's in 21st. Oof, he has a lot of work to do. Anyways, let's advance.
Good afternoon and welcome from Baku. This was the arena, if you think back to 2017, of one of the most eventful races of modern history, with controversy behind the safety car, last second overtakes, and a historic podium for Williams and for Lance Stroll. Let's find out what lies in store for us this year. It's time for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. With 20 turns and a length of 3.7 miles, Baku City Circuit in the heart of the Azerbaijan capital is a real test of a driver's endurance, patience, and precision. 90-degree corners through Sector 1 lead into a tightening uphill sprint as we start to circle around the old city. Then a 1.4-mile chase flat out through Sector 3 towards the finish line. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Max Verstappen put in a fantastic lap yesterday, and he'll start from pole position. And Lewis Hamilton completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Russell, Leclerc, Sergio Perez, and Sainz, Gasly, Ricciardo, Norris, and Fernando Alonso, Schofield, Tsunoda, Alex Albon, and Joe, Vettel, Magnussen, Lance Stroll, and Valtteri Bottas, Ocon, Latifi, Oscar Piastri, and Mick Schumacher. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. With the Grand Prix nearly upon us, Anthony Davidson is by my side once again to offer his perspective. Let's have a chat about McLaren. What do you make of their performance so far this season?
Well, the atmosphere within that team seems very positive at the moment. Everyone seems like they're in great spirits and having a lot of fun doing what they do, and that's definitely contributed to the performances we've seen.
Okay, here we are. Looks like we start P11th, and looks like my rival Ocon has got another penalty. Man, what's up with him and penalties, though? I actually don't understand. I'll increase up to a 0.1. Yep, should be fine. And my strategy is stop for lap 11 on the hearts. Okay. Let's go. Okay, here we go. 5 red lights for the Azerbaijan Grand Prix. Lights out, and away we go. Looks like Alonso got a better start there. He's on the inside of Daniel Ricciardo. The rundown turn one's not that long, so I have to be really careful. Whoa! There's a piece of debris flying. I wonder who it belongs to. Yuki Tsunoda just passed me for P11, but I retook it back. And I'm battling with the Alpine of Fernando. Battling for the final points paying position. I wonder whose front wing was that. It looks red, though. I don't know if it's a Ferrari or something else. I'll also try a dive boom bomb on the two McLarens. Oh, well, oh my goodness. That was so good. He almost got Norris there. Well, I got the inside line on Albon. So, and Albon had the break. Also, yeah, those high curbs, they can be a nuisance. And I hit the wall a little bit. I'm in a drag race with Alex Albon. Albon got me. The Williams straight line speed is good though. On the minimap, on the bottom left, I think... Oh, Ferrari must have came into the pits though. Yep. Yeah, he has a damaged front wing. Like, most likely, yeah. Here comes Yuki Tsunoda on me. Ugh. This is getting really annoying.
Ugh. Okay, we lost the position. Try to keep focus. Okay, DRS will be enabled this lap. You can use it when you're within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone.
That engine upgrade could be really useful right now. I think after Azerbaijan should be Canada. Yeah. But yeah, Canada is also another high-speed circuit, so yeah. Hopefully my upgrades will come by then.
Battery charge is high, let's use that overtake button a bit more. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 6.1 seconds.
We're getting close. Whoa, I think that a little too close. I have to cut the corner there, otherwise I would hit Alex Albon. And it's game over for me.
Head is increasing by a few tenths per lap. Get your head down.
Those high curbs are the death of me. Like that one. Those are high curbs. Sebastian Vettel's catching up to me. seriously, who came up for the idea of those high curbs or sausage curbs, whatever?
Okay, be careful. We think you're going to start losing some tire grip anytime now.
Here comes Sebastian Vettel.
We're approaching the pit window now, and you're going to be on hards next time. Gap to your teammate behind is 9.6 seconds.
Oh, that was a close one. Yep, Vettel got me.
Come on, you can win that place back.
If I can. And that was close.
Okay, gap ahead is 3.9 seconds. We're going to box this lap, push hard on the in lap.
Oh. myself and Vettel. Here comes Zhou Guan Yu and the two Aston Martins. Ugh. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Seriously? Ugh. Ugh. I cannot believe I was in a sandwich. They're double stacking Aston Martin?
Our gap to the car in front is 9.0 seconds.
Well, I cannot believe that they actually double stacked an Aston Martin.
Oscar is into the pit lane. Oscar in the pits. Green flag.
Someone was off. I think... Oh, there's an orange dot. It's a slow-moving McLaren. Okay, I can confirm the McLaren is a McLaren and it's Daniel Ricciardo. And another engine blowout. Ay 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 ay. When can McLaren and Ricciardo catch a break? Yeah, seriously. Like I said before, when can Ricciardo catch a break? I mean, he does not have a seat next year in reality though, so... Ugh.
The car ahead of you just fitted the hard tires. Car ahead, now on the hard compound. Right, let's have you in at the end of this lap, please. Pitting this lap, then. Come into the pits at the end of this lap. Great job from you and the crew there, mate. We're delighted with that. Pit strategy complete. See these tyres through to the end now.
Well, my rival's Esteban Ocon, and he's right on my tail. And these tires need time to warm up.
Okay, we think the underbody's incurred some slight damage, but nothing too serious at the moment. Just be careful.
And Ocon damaged my car. What the hell's wrong with this guy?
Keep on him, you might make a mistake. Okay, the underbody's taken some damage. You might start to notice it soon. Okay, we're looking at some gearbox wear, so try to keep the number of shifts to a minimum, please. Okay, some information on Piastri. They've got some kind of mechanical problem.
My teammate has mechanical problems. Then ask him to let me through. Here comes Lance.
The car ahead is 4.7 seconds.
Lance Stroll has overtaken me, of course. Aston Martin caught me. I try to be aggressive here. Ooh, slow down a bit. I have DRS. Pardon me, coming through. Oh, Yuki Tsunoda. Yuki, what the hell? How did he do that? Here comes Lance Stroll again on my right side this time. But I got the DRS on Yuki Tsunoda.
Lost one of the gears. The transmission is significantly damaged. We're down a gear, I'm afraid.
And add insult to Add more insult to injury, I lost fifth gear. Ugh.
Okay, bad news on the gearbox, I'm afraid. The team are trying everything they can think of, but they're not optimistic. Just keep at it, do your best, that's all we can ask. To the car in front is 2.7 seconds.
Fernando is out. I think he might be an engine failure as well.
We're leading our teammate by 7.7 seconds.
There's Fernando, and he's parked alongside the escape road, and yep, an engine failure. Ugh, not again. And he has a broken front wing as well. Holy shit. Ugh. Back to racing, and it looks like I got fifth gear back. Yep, I did.
Safety car's out. We need you to reduce your pace. It looks like there's a high amount of debris on the track. Be careful.
And the safety car is on track. Huh.
Okay, slow down, slow down. Your delta's negative, which means you're going too fast. Reduce your pace.
Should I pit or not pit? Well, if I pit now, then I lose track position. Looks like some of the guys are not pitting. Yep, I chose not to pit. Perez is pit for the softs.
Okay, that's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining. 5 laps of fuel left. Okay, overtake the safety car. You may overtake the safety car. It's waiting to pick up the leader. Right, drop your speed. Our delta's too low and we're going to risk a penalty. Slow your pace immediately.
I think it must be for Alonso, though. There's some debris on the track. And only a few laps to go anyway. I'm right behind Lance Stroll. I could overtake him now, but we're under safety car, so cannot. Okay. I wouldn't be surprised if there's like a one lap shootout.
Okay, let's get ready to go racing again. The safety car is in this lap. When the field accelerates, remember there's no overtaking until the timing line. Safety car in this lap.
And safety car's in this lap. What the fuck? By the way, Lance, can you speed up? I'm not fighting Paris here, so yeah. Yeah, I made the right decision not to pit, otherwise I would lose more places. Oh, Sergio Perez is on his team, on his old teammate, Lance Stroll. Looks like Sergio's got him. Side by side? Oh, that's new. I got Latifi behind me.
Okay, this is your final lap. Final lap of the race.
Alright, final lap of the race. I need to give it everything I got and make sure I finish. And ahead of Latifi. Max Verstappen wins the Baku, wins in Baku. Still got Latifi behind me though, but he's gonna overtake me eventually. But I think I may have a bit of an idea. Well, or not. I'm gonna be a P18. Get my all. I swerve to the left, to the right, and then made it. Whoa.
And that's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
Made it. Esteban Ocon, driver of the day.
Victory for the team from Milton Keynes. Then, after a quality performance. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
Here come today's winners. The team at Red Bull have done a phenomenal job recently, and it's clear to see that they've put in the work, and they should be so proud of the victory they've secured here.
Max Verstappen, followed by the... I think it's the two Mercedes here on the podium. Yep, it is. George Russell second, Hamilton third. Really, I don't know what is really going on with the engineering department. Well, have they fallen asleep on the job? Or did they went out to party and forgot to give me the upgrades? Ugh.
And now, let's take a look at the driver's standings. Max Verstappen should be pleased with his performance, making gains at the top of the table. Well, after an incredible day of racing, who was your driver of the day, Ant?
Difficult call, but I'd like to say Esteban Ocon. He's just so gifted at getting the most out of his tyres, and he showed that today.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. And pulling further ahead in the standings, it's Red Bull. Another team that excelled today were Williams, who make further progress up the table. It's been an absolutely wild weekend of Formula One action, and I can't wait to see what's next.
Okay, Ocon leads 18 to 16. That sucks. I got damage deductions. 6. $4.41 million. Alright, we're back. HQ. And it looks like one of my powertrain upgrades are here. Yeah, finally! The cylinder head. That's the upgrade I've been expecting. I've unlocked the piston upgrade. Ugh. Really? Right now? My goodness. I'll look into these later. Oh, it looks like my durability facility's gone upgrade. Oh yeah. Aha. Ah yes, this one. The max number of upgrades to development simultaneously is increased to 3. Ah yes. Ooh, a new durability factory upgrade. Very interesting. Like the tires keep bouncing. Anyways, I'm gonna leave this video out here for now. Don't forget to hit the like button, subscribe, turn on the notifications bell, share this video to your friends, family, and everyone else you know. Also, don't forget to follow my Twitch channel. The link is in the description below. So, thank you all for watching, and see you all next time. Oh, and don't forget to stay safe as well.
Just stay tight, we have to go.